Who's here to see the show?
All right, awesome.
Who's here for the timeshare presentation I'm about to do?
Nice. All right.
So where's everyone from? Anyone come from far away? Where'd you guys come from? Vegas? Who said Vegas? Vegas?
Vegas.
Henderson? All right, cool. How long did it take you to drive from Henderson? Oh, I am. Okay, cool. How does this go? Ventriloquism act. And honestly, that's pretty good. I flew in from Seattle to Vegas a couple days ago for the fair. It took me like 2 hours to drive from the airport to here. Like, there was no traffic. I just got stuck behind a minivan. I didn't want to pass because they were showing Finding Nemo.
Oh, my God.
Such a good movie, right? Minivan had one of those bumper stickers that caution baby on board. And when I finally passed, the driver was texting, right? I was so mad, I almost put my beer down.
Yeah.
I think you find your hair. The people who get offended at the church today. Anyone come from outside of the state? No. Where are you guys from? Chicago? From Utah. Ooh, what part of Utah? Lehigh? Oh, nice. That's very cool. Awesome. I've been there before. So I come from Seattle. Have you ever been to Seattle? It's a pretty cool city. Although when you're from Seattle, when you tell people you're from Seattle, especially here, people are always like, I could never live there. It rains a lot, right? And it does. It's not like a heavy rain. It's just like a drizzle. Like, you know when you go to the bathroom and you put your underpants back on, but a little bit comes out? That's what it's like in Seattle all the time. But, you know, the air is clean. The trees are green. I love growing up there because, like, you know, they're a little bit lenient on the laws in Washington, right? When I was a kid, I got arrested for something, but instead of putting me in juvenile detention, they gave me community service. And the community service they gave me, wait for it, was testing video games every weekend for a month.
Oh, wow.
Then when the video games came out, they gave me the video games for free. I got arrested 15 more times that year. I get arrested next week when Halo 7 comes out.
Right.
Well, I love it, man. I was gonna, you know, there aren't some kids here. There will be some adult jokes, but the kids get the jokes. It's really not my fault. How old are you, man? You got in any trouble as a little kid? Oh, yeah. He's like, yeah, I stabbed the guy yesterday. What do you think? You get in trouble at school? No. Okay, that's good. I'll tell you, this is a cool one to do. When I was a kid, me and my brother were like Bonnie and Clyde. Like, he let me wear the dress. But the coolest scam we had is, like, we went around the day after Halloween, and we'd knock on our neighbor's doors, and we would tell people that our aunt was in the hospital the night before, and we couldn't go trick-or-treating, and we asked them for all their leftover candy, and we got all of their candy.
Wow.
Like, we even convinced some people to give us cash. And we would have gotten away with it, but my stupid neighbor sent flowers to my dad's house, right? He was so mad, he made us split the cash with him. All right, that was a new joke I won't do again. Thanks for that silence, folks. That was nice. It was good. It was good. Thank you for that immediate feedback. Right. Hey, should we do a trick while we wait for a better performer to show up?
Yeah.
Who speaks English? He's like, a little bit. All right, folks, this is my last show here, so I'm just going to let you decide what you want to see. Now, COVID was a little tough for the entertainment industry, but I didn't let that go to waste. I learned a few new things. Now, these tricks are not in the show yet, so do you guys mind if I practice a trick before the show?
Yeah.
Can this be a judgment-free zone for 1 second? Thank you. Okay, now this is it. I'm going to let you decide what trick I do. You can do see the spoons, the arrow, or the bullwhip. One for spoon, two for arrow, three for bullwhip. Hold it up. What do you guys want to see? All right? Okay, we got lots of threes. Three, 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 three. We got a one. Okay, we'll do the bullwhip. All right. Bullwhip. Let's do it. All right. Bear with me, folks. Remember, this is just a trick I'm working on, and then we'll get into the show. All right. So, got a bullwhip? Now, this bullwhip's been in my family for generations. My great-grandmother was a bull tamer. She passed this down to my grandmother, who was a bull tamer, who passed this down to my father, who made up those stories about my grandma. Yeah, he's just horrible. Now, this is not a traditional bullwhip. not made of animal hide, which means the vegan bullwhip, which also means it's skinnier than other bullwhips, and it tells you regularly that it's better than you. Yeah. It's actually made of, the reason it's green, it's made up of 7 organic bales of kale. Yeah, I just read yesterday that organic is an old Latin term for hippies will buy anything. Now, it's a pretty cool treat in and of itself, right? A couple of the kids are scared, a couple of the husbands are like, I gotta do the dishes. Now, we won't stop there, folks. We're gonna try and do something dangerous. I'm gonna attempt to light some matches out from my hand, only using the bullwhip. Thank you, folks. All right, remember, this is something I'm working on. I watched a YouTube video of a guy doing this and he lost his finger. What?
What?
I probably won't lose my finger. There's enough of you that will help me find it, right? All right, remember, this is just a trick I'm working on, then we'll start the big show. And then you guys can tell me if it's a trick I should keep working on. All right, here we go. Lighting these out from my hands. Here we go. Oh, jeez.
Damn.
Okay, if I could do that correctly, 5 being the coolest, 1 being the worst, how cool would it be? 4, 4, 4, 1 with the middle finger, that's unnecessary. Just don't do it. 2, thank you. Tough crowd. All right, let's start the actual show. Now, how this works, folks, I'm going to go backstage, introduce myself. When I introduce myself, all I want you to do, clap, cheer, treat it like it's the most awesome rock show you've ever been to in your entire life. Then we start the big show with the Fire of the Knives. At the end of the show, I'll throw a baby up into a doll chair and balancing on my face. You guys ready? You guys are doing the best. Oh yeah, ladies and gentlemen, the performer about to watch him all the way from Seattle, where he's voted Seattle's funniest variety comic. You may have seen him on America's Got Talent, Last Comic Standing, ESPN, and The Late Late Show with James Corden. He's broken 5 Guinness World Records, performed for presidential candidates, overseas for American troops in 13 different countries. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a loud round of applause to extremely funny man, Mr. Matt Baker! Introduce me to, huh? What a sexy voice that guy has. Hey folks, what a dream come true. My mom said if I was practiced hard enough, one day I might perform for 75 people in Logandale, so thank you so much. I was like, what about Vegas, Mom? She's like, don't get your hopes up. Focus on a town with no stoplights. My name is Matt Baker, or as they refer to me in Mexico, is El Diablo Blanco, which I think roughly translates to a handsome man. Now, I do jokes and weird skills. Like I said, I'm just going to let you guys decide throughout the show what you want to see. So to start the show, you can see the Chinese yo-yo, or you can see some cool juggling to music. A loud round of applause, you want to see some cool Chinese yo-yo to music? A loud round of applause, you want to see some juggling to music?
Yeah!
Oh. A loud round of applause, you really just don't care what I do, want me to stop talking and do something already? Thank you. They're like, speed it up. We came a long way. All right. I guess juggling, that never wins. All right. Now, I love juggling. I've been doing it since I was a kid. I always ask people why they think juggling's not on television. I always try to sing responses. Some people say it's because it's boring, which I think is funny because people watch golf. I will start a little bit of juggling. Anytime you see something you like, something you can't do yourself, I want you to do clap cheer. I want you to go crazy like they do in Mesquite when diapers go on sale at Walmart. Right, folks? Yeah, they went from Mesquite? No. I was in Mesquite, doing a show in a casino a few years ago, and I asked the audience if anyone was famous from Mesquite, and this guy yells out, Kevin Bacon's sister lives here. I was like, you could have just said no. So, we're trying some music, do some cool juggling tricks, pumping you guys up. Let's do this. Aw, yeah. Aw, what? Yeah. Be sure to donate money to the Preventing White People from Dancing Fund. Aw, yeah. It's like you know the moves, oh yeah. That's the cougar, I learned it at Zumba. Here we go.
Yeah.
about to go down. If you've been drinking on Juggling 7, so that guy was so good. Some tricks. The show. Hey, that was my mom's favorite routine, right? Yeah. That's for you, Mom. Yeah. She's not dead. I don't know why I do that. It's so sensitive. Alright, let's hear. Isn't this crazy? This is my job. I've been doing this since I was 17 years old. I actually started with the skill of hacky sack. Does anyone remember hacky sack at all?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll explain hacky sack to those who stayed in school. Now, hacky sack is a game where you keep a bag in the air only using your feet. This is a true story. When I was 17, I moved to Europe. I was sponsored by Snickers Candy Bars. They paid me money to play hacky sack, which made me a professional hacky sack player. And being a professional hacky sack player, that's like telling the entire world, hey, I suck at normal sports.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a World Hacky Sack Championships every single year. That's absolutely true. It's a real recognized sport. Like, I don't ever think it'd be the Olympics because they test for drugs. But there is a World Hacky Sack Championships. I competed in 2017. I took 8th place at the World Hacky Sack Championships. Woo! Thank you, sir. Don't give me too much credit. There are only 9 competitors. I beat somebody, right? Yeah, that's pretty. That little girl I beat was really good. All right. So anyway, she competed with only one leg. Here we go. Just jokes. So here we go. Couple cool hacky sack maneuvers for the fine people of Clark County. Here we go. Couple cool hacky sack maneuvers. Oh, almost messed up. Here we go. Oh, almost messed up again. It's not like you guys are gonna climb your knees. Oh, what? Here we go. We'll do the big finish. Do the big finish. Why am I missing this? There it is. Oh. You're just clapping because it stopped. Like the suffering is over. It is a good workout though. I can feel it in the glutes right here. It burns. Yeah. It's a great joke, no glutes are. Now I'm gonna do the 2 hardest hacky sack tricks in the entire world for all you care. For the first one, I'm gonna throw it from behind my back. It's gonna go around my head. It's gonna fall on the other side of my body. I'll catch it behind my back with my other foot. Now this hacky sack is a bit different than the ones you may have seen before. This one is handmade. It's made up of 32 individual panels and is filled with my father's broken dreams. I wish that was a joke. All right, here we go. Around the head, half as fast. Not bad for a 35-year-old, right? Yeah, I'm 40. There I am. I'm going to do the hardest hacky sack trick I can do. I'll attempt to give 2 hacky sacks in the air with only 1 foot. I'll do it in a unique way. Not only will I keep 2 hacky sacks in the air, I'll also be doing it while escaping from these European handcuffs. My therapist tells me I do escapes from my show because I have abandonment issues. I don't think that's the case, but it definitely explains why I pee on my roommate's shoes when she leaves. Sorry, she thinks it's my dog. At least that's what it says in her journal. My wife hates that joke because I refer to her as my roommate. Now, to do this particular trick, I'm going to need a female, an adult woman to help me out with this. An adult female, let's see here. Adult female. This, you're holding a bunch of teddy bears. That makes me think you're maybe not an adult. All right, she's like, come on up, let's give her a loud round of applause. Thank you so much. This is going to be great. Bring your own teddy bear. It's your emotional support teddy bear. Let me get you some cool music. Aw, yeah. What? Oh. Oh, right, easy, Micho. Easy. All right. What's your name? Kelly, nice to meet you. Where are you from, Kelly? Thanks. All right, now, Kelly, all you want to do is inspect these, make sure they are European shackles, something you might find at the baby gap. Just confirm the ground, there's no triggers, anything that will allow me to get out easily. Kelly? Very thorough. Thank you so much. You didn't even look. I hope you don't work for TSA. All right, now, Kelly, there's two chains. You can wrap them around my right wrist. Lock me in with this padlock as tightly as you can. Just make sure to leave enough room for me to get out. Now, I do a lot of different escapes. My most famous escape to date is I got out 1 year early on my Verizon cell phone plan. Yeah. You're very good at this. Do you have kids? Okay, all right. That is a beautiful wedding ring. Is that quartz? That's so nice. All right, now, there's two hacky sacks right there. You had to pick them up. Hey, what was it, Kelly? Is that what I said, right? Kelly, all right. What I want you to do is just place them one at a time on my feet. Those are my hands, Kelly, just a small difference. Yeah. Perfect. We'll do the left one, and then we'll do the right one. And then Kelly, I just said kind of just stand on the right hand side, very cool. Alright, we're still in. Now folks, if we keep the two hacky sacks in the air, we're only using one foot. I'm gonna throw one hacky sack to Kelly. Kelly's gonna attempt to catch one. Alright, so cup them. Perfect, right? And then come a little closer, like maybe like right there. Right, here we go. Still, right here. Two hacky sacks, one foot. Oh, it totally dropped one, Kelly. Just grab that. Thank you so much. You're so great. High five. Listen, Kelly. You're so great. All right, here we go. Still in, Kelly. Here we go. Two accents. One foot. Or the Kellinator. All right. The Kellinator. All right. I've been messing up so poorly. So, all right. So get ready for it to fly. All right. Here. Two accents. One foot. Oh, Kelly. Here comes Kelly. Catch that one. Catch this one. Catch that one. Let's give Kelly a round of applause. Kelly! I messed it up, you did so good. Booty bump, boom. Now, Kelly, for helping me out, you're gonna get something very cool. You were gonna get a Matt Baker Comedy Show sticker, estimated value. Awesome. Or you can have a mysterious, mediocre prize. Cool sticker with my face on it, it's a scratch and sniff. Or a mysterious, mediocre prize. Mysterious mediocre prize you're gonna get, Kelly, is a Ricky Martin postcard! Yeah! You're awesome. Thank you so much, Kelly. She was excited about the postcard. She's like, that's the one I don't have. So good. Was that an engagement ring? Are you guys actually married? Engagement ring? Congratulations. That's so cool, man. Yeah. Were you nervous about the engagement ring? Yeah. They said engagement ring is supposed to be 3 months of a man's salary, which is great for me because I just got something from a vending machine. I got married 2 years ago, and the reason I'm not wearing a wedding ring is I said to my wife, I'm like, babe, we should get tattoos of our wedding rings on our fingers. And she's like, no way, tattoos are forever. Now, I've been doing this a long time. I started when I was 17 years old with the hacky sack. It's totally true. When I was 18, I taught English to students from Great Britain. When I was 19, I was in a circus. Went all around the world, was part of the circus. There was a show, Circus Thomason, extremely low budget, did not have a lot of money. It was not like Cirque du Soleil, it was more like Cirque de Poverté. Now, the reason I bring this up is I used to perform a stunt in that circus, and do it for you this afternoon now. It's with a childish object, so you're gonna have to play along just a little bit. I'm gonna do a stunt with this horse right here. Yeah. It's called a couple different things. It's called a horse on a stick or an equestrian kebab. In Pennsylvania, it's referred to as an Amish motorcycle. Now, does anyone have their own horse here? Does anyone have their own horse? Has anyone heard of a horse before? Huh. Okay, about half the crowd. That's cool. All right, now, how this works. I'm going to balance this horse on my foot, just like this. I'm going to kick the horse off my foot for this afternoon. I'm going to attempt to catch this horse on my face. What? To do this, I'll need some help from a child. I need some help from a kid in the age range of 5 to 11. Let's do 5 to 11. All right. Oh, there's a bunch of kids. I need kids sitting quietly. quietly. Just sitting quietly. Listen to the criteria first before you ruin it for the kid. Sitting quietly, raising your hand, I need a kid with mid to below average intelligence. Oh, yeah, okay. Let's see here. The dude right there, with the white shirt, the black sleeves, did you want to help out? Come on up, let's give this kid a loud round of applause. It's gonna be good. Let me get you some cool music, dude. Yeah, come on up. Stand right here. Alright, put your hands to the sides. Alright, head forward. Don't move. It's gonna get super weird. Is that too tight? It's good? Okay, cool. Whatever you do, don't move, okay? What is wrong with you people? Jeez! No one moved at all! The family's filming? They're like, we lost our child, but we got a million YouTube views. It's totally worth it. I mean, don't look at me, dude. None of these people are your friends, all right? No one. I'm your only ally here. What's your name? Orion? That's cool. Turkey, where you from, Orion? You're from Nevada? Heard of it? Yeah? Snail? All right, how old are you? You're turning 12. That's so awesome. Yeah, narcissist. Now, Orion, I'm going to catch a foursome in the face. You saw how excited people were about that. Now, you're going to help build the theatrical tension, Orion. What you're going to do is you're going to stand behind this drum, Orion, and you, my man, are going to give me a little drum roll. All right, let's hear it, buddy. Dude, that's awesome. Look at that. The best applause of the whole show, man. That's great. Dude, we should go on the road together and start a band. You want to do that? We'll call our band the Jehovah's Witness Protection Program. I'll take 100%, you take 0%. Is that cool? Let's do it. All right, cool. All right, here we go. It's about accurate for what drummers make. All right, here we go. Catching a horse on the face with Orion on the drum. Anytime, dude, that was the idea. Do this, the other one's pretty sweet. All right, we're going to do a little practice round. Yeah, okay, remember the thing that I talked about? And then you do that, and then we're going to combine the two. It's going to be so sweet. All right, here we go. Yeah. Oh, keep going. You're doing so good, all right? Keep going. Not enough horsepower. No. Hit the cymbal! Hit the gold thing! Hit the other thing! Hit the higher thing! Hit the smaller round thing! Hit the flying saucer! Hit the UFO! Yeah! Right on cue! Alright, give me the drumsticks, alright? Now, you're not done yet. Behind this table, on the little riser there, there's a hat. All I want you to do is grab the hat, Orion. Alright, let me feel it. What are you doing? Alright, that's a war helmet, not a hat. I need a hat. Not something you wear in World War I, yeah. Yeah, dude, there's a stack of hats. What are you doing? Yeah, you were the hat. All right, cool. All right, it's very simple. What I want you to do is place the hat on top of the horse's head. All right? I'm gonna come to you, all right? I'm gonna sit down on the stage. Where did you put the helmet? Okay, we're good, all right. Can't have that one again. Yeah, anytime. Good job. Take that. Jump on the drum. The drum! All right. Yes! Oh, Ryan! You did great, dude! Come on over here. Chest bump. Oh, yeah. All right. Yeah, just look at the stuff, yeah. All right. Yeah. He's like, what do I get out of this box? All right, do you want to do another one? You good? You good, okay. All right, for helping me out, you're going to get something very cool. You're going to get some Matt Baker comedy show. Stationary? Or you can have a mysterious mediocre prize. Cool stationery or mysterious mediocre prize? Mysterious mediocre prize. Mysterious mediocre prize you're going to get, Orion, is a Willie Nelson 8-track! Yeah! Right? Orion, that was a joke. Seriously, come back. No kid's ever taken that before. All right, can I give you something more current than this? Okay, you're gonna get a Duran Duran cassette tape! Yeah. Alright, seriously, come back, dude, seriously. Probably the easiest kid to get Christmas gifts for, alright. Stand right here, face the crowd, act like you're swimming with one arm. Okay. You had a rave or something? All right. Backstroke. Yeah. Nice. Butterfly. Do the butterfly. Yeah. That's good. Wounded koala. Oh, gosh. Just put your wrist out like that. I was born in 1981. This is very popular around this range. It's called the slap bracelet. It's all yours, Orion. Let's go, Orion. Loud. Orion, seriously, come back, dude. Seriously. Orion, get out of here. Get out of here. That's a joke. Seriously. Orion, seriously, come here, man. Come here. Alright, is that cool? Is that okay? Is a prize? Alright, nice. You're in luck, because normally I sell those after the show, but the fair won't let me because they have lead paint in them. So just chew it up, alright? Is this your sister? Come here. I'm going to give you something you can share with your sister. Here you go, Ryan. Take this, buddy. This is something you can share with your sister. Do you want it? Do you not want to share with your sister?
No.
He's like, sorry to make you walk again, dude. There, that's a card that will take you to a website that will show you like different slap bracelet tricks that you can learn how to do. If you want to share with your sister, you need a photocopy, right? Yeah. I would do it myself, I just don't like photocopiers that make my butt look big. Good luck to you guys decide what you get. Thank you for laughing at that. I think that's like my favorite joke ever. All right, I'm going to do a musical routine because I think the music's a little bit better than the jokes right now. Here we go, some cool music with some hat tricks. Here we go, let's do this thing. Thank you. what the hell we weren't supposed to see. Thank you, Orion. This is not supposed to be a surprise. Woo! Nothing. Yes. We practiced 25 years. Logan Dale. We got llamas to pet. All right, we're like, this is my job. Isn't this wild? Right? A lot of people are surprised at that. They're like, really, you make money doing this? It's like, yeah, how do you think I make my payments on my 2001 Kia Sorento? Right? And it was tough the last 2 years. You know, COVID hit the entertainment industry pretty hard. I had to like perform out of my garage online, like do Zoom shows. It was just tough. Like, you perform with these people, you can't, they're all muted, you can't hear them at all. And all my comedian friends are like, do you have a hard time, like, doing jokes and not being able to hear people laugh? I'm like, I've been doing that my whole career. Have you seen my Logan Dale shows? It's very Zoom-ish. All right. Now, like I said, I'm going to really decide what you want to see throughout the rest of the show. You can decide for the next one, you can see something with kids, because I'm clearly very good with them, or you can see something dangerous. A lot of applause. You want to see something with children? I think that was about all the kids in the crowd right there. A lot of applause. You want to see something dangerous? Loud round of applause, you want to see something dangerous with children? This is a sad stuff. What's wrong with you? It ain't a real fair until a kid gets sacrificed right now. I'm going to do something dangerous with a kid. I'm going to balance a dumb forehead. I'm going to throw a baby up. It's going to land sitting in the doll chair. Does anyone have a baby? Dude, is that your baby or did you win at the carnival? 6 months? All right, well, that's a little too old. I brought my own baby. It's a BYOB. Mine's a special baby. Mine's a knife baby! Knife baby! Maybe your kid can grow up to do this. Hold knives. Now, I don't have kids of my own. I do have older parents. So it's kind of similar. But this is my little knife baby. Maybe she's my adopted knife baby. She started to ask questions where she came from. I didn't know how to answer her. So what I did is I took a piece of her hair. I sent it in to get DNA tested. It turns out she's from Taiwan. I love the DNA test. You guys done it? It's crazy. I did it last year. Learned a lot about myself. Like my whole life, I thought I was French. Turns out I'm 63% water. All right, here we go. Now I'm going to balance the doll chair on my forehead. I'm going to throw the baby up and do a full flip, and she'll land sitting in the doll chair.
Naf baby!
Naf baby! Or for my Spanish-speaking friends, bebe con cuchillo. Yeah. Did I say it right? Anyone speak Spanish? Did I say it correctly? All right, cool. I've been practicing. I know the basics. Like, donde están mis bebe con cuchillo? Donde están mis... pantalones. All right. All right, here we go. Balance it up. Should we give her a name? What's the name should we give her?
Taylor.
What's that? Hannah.
Addie.
Oh, Addie. Okay. That's really specific.
What
is that from something? All right, we'll go with Addie. All right, cool. I've had like Helen Killer, Edna Scissorhands, Carol Baskin. Right. I like Addie. All right, here we go. Knife baby, knife baby. Here we go. It's funny, like, the first time I ever performed Knife Baby, I was performing on a cruise ship, and I pulled the Knife Baby out, and the woman in the back row, she goes, how come you don't comb her hair? It's like, that's the thing that's bothering her. Like, it'd be way more weird if I was backstage combing her hair before I come on. All right, let's do another, should we do another dangerous one? More danger? All right, we got 10 minutes, all right? Let me think about this. All right, I'm gonna do a dangerous one, but before I do that, I need 3 kids in the age range of 4 to 8 years old for this one. 4 to 8, 4 to 8, 4 to 8, 4 to 8. In the blue, come on up. We need two boys. What are we going to do? That's not 4 to 8. Come on. Guess. Right here. With Yep. All right. And we'll also... Did you think I called on you? Here, you can come up, dude. Come on up, dude. Oh, no, change mine. All right. In the blue, come on up. Let's give all three of these kids a loud round of applause. It's gonna be good. Come on over here. All right. Stand right here. Lovely lady in the middle. Guess on the left, blue on the right. Now what's gonna happen? I'm gonna count to three. On three, these kids are gonna bust their best dance moves. On three, bust your best dance moves. Oh yeah. 1, 2, 3. Bust it. Go. Ooh. Look. Feel like an Irish jig. An Irish jig. That is crazy. All right, easy guys, easy. Goodness gracious, that was crazy. Man, that was like how crop circles are made. All right, nice. Everyone go shoulder to shoulder with the Irish jig lady, all right? Shoulder to shoulder with the Irish jig lady. Do you have a question? What's your question?
So how do you do these tricks?
You're about to find out, all right? All right, so go shoulder to shoulder with her, okay? Nice. Okay, I'm going to get a couple names. What's your name?
Martin.
Athena.
Maxim.
That's crazy. That's the name of all my ex-girlfriends. So what's going to happen? We're going to ask these three kids a series of adult questions. If they think they know the answer to the adult question, they're going to raise their hand. If they get the question correct, they'll get a point. The kid with the most points at the end of the game show will walk away with a valuable prize. I'm not going to tell you what it is because you might not play, but it's very good. Okay? Very first adult question. What color is SpongeBob? Ma'am.
Yellow,
you are correct. Right, folks? Yeah, we can clap. We can clap for the kids at least, right? Next question. What is your favorite number, sir?
Five.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. What's his favorite number?
One.
You are correct. Good job. Yeah. 1 point for you. No points for you. Next question. Between the three of you, who does not have a point yet? Sir?
I do not have a point.
You are correct. Everyone's on the board. Yeah. All right. 1 point for everybody. All right. And these are sound effect questions. You have to raise your hand to make the sound. What sound does a dog make? Ma'am. Yeah. What sound does a giraffe make? Sir. You are correct. Good job. All right. Next. Next question. What sound does your dad, uncle, or grandfather make when they're sleeping? Ma'am. That's the weirdest snore ever. They snore and then just break out laughing. All right. All right. Next question. What sound does your mom, aunt, or grandmother make when they're angry? Yeah.
Nothing.
What happens when they get angry at you, dude?
I forgot.
What about you? You ever, people get angry at you? What do they sound like?
I forgot.
Okay. All right. Being political. I like it. All right. Next. Nice. All right. These are yes or no questions, so you can just say the words yes or no. Do you understand? Okay, very first yes or no question. Yes or no, if a tree falls on a mine in the forest, does anyone care?
No.
Yes or no? If a tree falls on a mine in the forest, does anyone care? Sir?
Yes.
Yes, because the tree will die. You are correct. Next question. Let's go. Yes or no? Yes or no, does a feminist still want flowers on Valentine's Day? All right, let's get that. Next question. No one really knows, I know. All right, next question. Is it possible for a comedian to ever get married? Ma'am?
Yes.
Yes, it is, ladies. Yes, it is. All right. Yeah. All right. Now, this is the honesty round, so you have to raise your hand and be as honest as possible, okay? Now, we're very divided as a country right now. What sounds cooler, the Democratic Party, the Republican Party, or a birthday party? Ma'am?
Birthday party.
Yeah, all right. Like it. Nice. Next question. What is the coolest thing that you've ever stolen? Sir?
A Nintendo Switch.
Oh. Pretty good. Stolen anything cool?
I don't know.
nothing.
All right, cool, man. That's so awesome. Nintendo Switch, he stole this guy. That's so cool. Man, your prize is getting grounded. All right, nice. All right, next question. Between the three of you, who can raise their hand the slowest? Okay, you guys tied for it. And the last question, between the three of you, think about this, boys. Who is the cutest? Who's the cutest?
My sister.
Your sister, okay. Between the three of you.
I don't know.
Who's the cutest, dude?
You.
Ah. You are correct. That was not even part of the show. That was awesome. Thank you, dude. Alright, you're each equally cute for helping me out. You're going to each get something very cool. You're going to each get a certificate of appreciation for being an awesome audience member. Let's give each of our kids a loud round of applause. We got the prize, we're walking away, we're leaving the stage, we're moving our legs and a bottom falls. Hey, get off the stage, 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 hey, kids, get off the stage, hey, get off the stage, hey. You guys can leave anytime, that was the idea, yeah. You gotta leave. Or I'm gonna tell people you stole a Nintendo Switch, dude. You guys gotta. Dude, the parents for these kids! Alright, there you are. Alright, see you guys. They're like, you need me for this show. Alright, I'm gonna do one more. And I'll get you guys out of here. Thank you so much for letting me be part of your community just for a few days. I'm gonna catch a bowling ball on my face. Yeah. Right? What's that? I didn't understand what it said. Alright, so real bowling ball. It is 6 pounds, 7 ounces, the exact same size as me when I was born. Can you imagine my mom shooting this bad boy out? Boom! Strike. I know we're not all American here, some of you might be from Texas. Does anyone know what 6 pounds, 7 ounces is in kilos? You guys? Three? How do you guys know that? Oh, you saw the show before. Like, we came, we wanted credit for someone else's answer. Do you guys go to public school? Yeah, okay, yes. I think you're doing a good job, stealing the answers. No, I just read an article that ranks U.S. public education system against other countries in different subjects in math. We're 25th. We're behind Ireland. It's like, who knew that learning to count by singing 99 balls of beer on the wall is effective? We're 19th in geography. We're behind a bunch of countries I've never even heard of. Okay. That response proves a point. All right, here we go. I never went to public school myself. I was homeschooled until my parents found out. Bowling ball to the face. All right, if I could have everyone count down from three. 3, 2, 1! Seriously, guys? You guys won't let me do anything. Alright, if you think this is a bad idea, you should see the things that didn't make it in my show. Check this one out. This is so stupid. To the face. If you like the show, after the show, I'll be hanging out right here. I think I have a few trading cards left. Comedy Central trading cards, absolutely free. What's that? You want the 8-track? Amazing. We'll see. I got trading cards. I also have stickers that are absolutely free that anybody wants to come grab a sticker. I also sell DVDs. They're only $5. All right, here we go. Right here. Bowling ball to the face. You guys have been awesome. My name's Matt Baker. In case I forget, here we go. What's that? You want Abby and the doll? Normally I have a caution knife baby on board stickers, but I had sold out of them. So if you want one, shoot me an email. I'll send you one. All right, here we go. Bully ball to the face. If I can have everyone count down from three. Three, two, one. Hey folks, thank you so much for coming out and supporting the fair. I will see you guys later.